Hello, dear friends. Today I want to share with you my knowledge about how to correctly write a script for the Saw Bubble Show. This topic is the first one among other in my master classes, and it takes from 1 to 2 hours to tell about it depending on the training program. So process yourself. I will try to speak as brief as possible and I hope that it won't take long. So, I always start explaining this topic with the fact that you need to understand that there are three classifications of the Saw Bubble Show. First, you have a program, the Saw Bubble Show program. It consists of a performance and an interactive part. A performance is a time when you don't interact with the audience. It doesn't mean that you shouldn't look at them and ignore them in various ways. It should be without a direct interacting. You don't invite the audience to yourself, you only show tricks. The music is playing and everything is beautiful, wonderful, you inflated the bubble, showed it, demonstrated it, and everything is wonderful, great. This is performance. Interaction with the audience during the performance can only be in such a way as, for example, you caught a bubble, looked at the audience, showed it, looked at the bubble, blew a few bubbles, showed them, and continued. Oops, let it out, stood up, they applauded you. This is the only interaction with the audience and they are not invited anywhere. This part of your show is a performance. The part when you invite the audience to you, ask them to inflate the bubble using racket, or you come to them and do something for them, or set a fire on somebody's hand, this is the interactive part. Putting the person into the bubble is also, of course, an interactive part, and altogether is your program for show. Initially, we'll speak about the performance. So, any performance of the Saw Bubble Show is based on a very simple elementary formula. We go from small bubbles to big ones, and then to putting the person inside the bubble. That is, the first we should do is the bubbles that fly from the hands. Inflate the smallest bubbles first. If you don't work with your hands, then use the racket to blow the smallest bubbles. Then there will be bigger bubbles, then they become bigger and bigger, and also gradually we reach the point of putting the person into the bubble. Of course, we do tricks in the process. Well, for example, you can make a caterpillar using this racket. Exactly in the period of time when I made a throw with this racket, then I can already start to making a caterpillar. If I use this racket, I put it away and don't use it anymore. The most common question is, when is the time for making fire bubble and using light table in this whole variety of tricks? And also, when it's the proper time to insert the frame, so look, in my personal opinion, the fire bubble trick should be done inside the manual block. And this time, your hands are wet. And this is the best time to do this trick, so to say. As for the light table, I insert it in such a way. I use this racket, then I use a 20 cm diameter racket. You may see what size of bubble it blows, about this size. It's similar to the size we make on a light table, but still a little smaller. Then I make a rain of bubbles with the bubble maker and then move on to the light table. I work on it with the vertical frame. I don't use both the table and the frame in one program because this will be too much for one program. So, after that, I work on the light table. Well, and after that, I take the loop rackets, 30 cm racket, a 45 cm racket, there are Christmas trees and some sectional rackets. This is the principle that your performance will always be built on. Thank God we are done with it. Next thing. Then the question is when, in what program and how do we put the interactive parts correctly? In fact, there are no very strict rules here, but there is logic and common sense. I call you to use common sense. Let's compare to different weddings as an example. The first wedding, luxury wedding, a huge beautiful restaurant, white hall, stunning light, people sit at the tables, men are in such beautiful suit coats, women are in evening dresses, drink wine from thin glasses, and you walk in, here is the question. Will it be appropriate to insert an interactive part inside your performance? When you come to someone who is sitting at the table, pull them to your stage, make them dance next to you with a racket, or do something like that during the performance. Of course, this is not a good idea. People will sit, culturally drink wine and watch, contemplate your performance on a frame, on a table, on something like this. Here, the interactivity inside the performance is inappropriate. Here, it must be after the performance. In other words, you showed your entire program, then called, let's say, the newlyweds. You have done your job with them. Well, that's what can it be? To blow into hot rackets, for example, inflate some bubbles, put them inside a bubble, if all this is agreed with them in advance. Then you can invite your guests to put them into a soap bubble. If they want to, they go. If they don't want to, they don't go. That's it. It's very simple. And let's imagine another situation. You come to a wedding where we have 20 people. The wedding takes place in a cafe where there is no host at all. And you come, there are people sitting, they are already tired of everything that is happening around them. They are almost picking their noses because of boredom. And then some girls arrives. She's trying to show them something. They get very sad. They start talking to each other. How to attract attention to yourself? Yes, of course, you need to ensure the interactive activities as early as possible. You came, you saw the situation, what she wants from us. That's the language they are speaking in this cafe. And you're like, okay, you take racket, you choose today's victim on this holiday, let it be this boy. Come here, boy, take the racket too, a racket for the boy, a racket for you, come on, let's dance with me, blow some bubbles, everything's cool, done. People realize that they would be invited from the table, they got ready for this and began to watch carefully. Well, again, it's funny for them when one of their drinking buddies come out to the stage and start inflating bubbles. Someone was burned, I mean. They were invited to make a free bubble in the process, also funny. According to what principle you make interactive parts? If you worked with a 10-centimeter racket, then invite a person and give him a 10-centimeter racket. If you work with fire, then invite someone and burn the person, not to death. If you worked with a 30-centimeter racket, then invite someone and give them 30-centimeter racket. If they wanted a man, let's say, to wave to someone from the form on the light table, then invite the person and let him wave his hand. You don't need to wait for the moment when it's time to interact with the audience. Here it will be appropriate to insert interactive parts inside the performance. And it will be the same to almost all adult events. You should work using this principle of common sense. I hope you understood and I didn't bore you too much. Let's talk, and I'll try to talk briefly about interactive activities at a children's holiday. So, we have a children's holiday. These are small children, small about 2 or 4 years old children in a kindergarten. So they sit down and stare at me. Of course, it's useless to drag them to do some interactive actions, useless to take them by the hand, to pull them out on the stage, to make them program for 40 minutes. God forgive me. By the way, the program for such children should not last more than 20 minutes. This is the psychological norm of this child. It can't be longer. So you calmly, without expression, without being into this stage image, without this and without insisting, here it is, baby, you like it, yes, without this, please, do your job carefully. You don't use loud music, no bright makeup, it's not necessary here, none of this is necessary. You should be as much like a normal person as possible. You inflated a bubble, you say, oh, bubble, cool. They're sitting like this usually, they don't tell you anything, no feedback at all, completely no reaction. Inflate a couple more bubbles and say, great, come on, let's clap. This is the kind of interaction we'll have with these small kids. If there are no parents near them, well, the maximum you can come to them like this, bubbles will fall near them and carefully watch how they react. If no one is crying, if no one is afraid, you can try to make further contact, but in no case don't fool them. If children of this age don't want to go to the bubble, Don't drag them here, for God's sake. Don't do that. Don't frighten the children. So I think we figured it out. Let's finish with talks about kindergarten first and speak about birthday parties. Kids who are older, they are interested in interactive activities, of course. They are no longer afraid of anyone, they are already trying to contact with you. And here the situation is different. If not whole kindergarten is on this event, where 100 person is sitting, this one is a mass holiday, of course, on mass event. There is no question of any interactivity at all, except putting kids into the bubble after the performance. If this is just a group of children, you can insert, or rather have to insert, interactive activities somewhere between your performance. I think you should insert one for every 5 minutes. You blow some bubbles and then call the kids. There are about 30 children in the group. You should call the first 5 kids, put them on the stage and say, Sasha, Masha, Petya, and there are 2 more children. Let's also try to do it. And the other kids will clap for us. Okay. So you give them a racket and say, you're going to throw a bubble out like this, okay? Okay. Then the first kid takes the racket, all others are waiting. The first kid throws a bubble away, you say, thank you, sit down, please. The second kid throws out, thank you, sit down, please, and so on. In the next interactive insert, call the next 5 children, saying, and you guys will burst the bubbles. Waved over them with the bubble maker, they burst the bubbles and then sit them down, and so on. These interactive inserts will help children not to get bored by keeping an eye on those who are sitting so that they clap and participate in some way, somehow. Definitely every child should participate. Then we move on to happy birthday parties. They are, of course, children of mixed age. Again, the rules with interactive inserts also work in this case. Interactive insertion is preferably needed during the program. Children's programs are all programs that are made for kids up to 11-12 years old. If kids are older, it's an adult program, and then we follow the rules I mentioned above. But let's go back to the kids. There is one exception. These are holidays that are not exactly children's holidays. For example, a mother thinks that this is a children's holiday, but in fact it's not. The mother calls and says, hello, I need a children's soap bubble show. You say, yes, of course, there is such a price, everything is negotiated. If you have both a children's and adult's costume, you wear a children's costume for the performance. You come to a cafe and see a bad scene. Beautiful women and men are sitting in beautiful dresses. They have only one child in their arms, about 3 years old, maybe younger than 3 years old. Well, there may still be a couple other kids somewhere in the hall, mostly adults, say, sit there. And they have a children's soap bubble show, and you are there in some extra childish costume. Well, I don't even know what to give as an example. Well, Peppa the Pig is too hard, because I actually hope that no one use. Well, in general, you have a child's costume. You have freckles drawn on you and something that make anyone clearly see childish theme. It will look inappropriate. That's why you should ask questions. Where the event takes place? How many children will be there? How many adults? Convince, ask questions. The more questions you ask, the more you know about the holiday, the more appropriate script you will be able to make for this particular holiday. I hope you don't get too tired. If you like this video and you are not tired, put a like on it. And if you have questions or comments related to this topic, of course, write them down in the comments below. I will read it and, of course, answer you. And subscribe to my channel. I will be glad to see you again. Bye-bye!